Deep in the Cretaceous period lived a team of daring explorers set out on an extraordinary quest. They entered the unknown depths of a primeval forest armed with cutting-edge equipment and a quest for knowledge, keeping an eye out for any indication of the elusive monster they sought. They were the greatest of the best and the foremost authorities on the paranormal occurrences in ancient history. This deadly creature was none other than Spectrovenator. Spectrovenator is a genus of basal abelisaurid theropod dinosaurs that lived in what is now Brazil during the early Cretaceous. It was one of the smallest known abelisaurids, measuring just 2 meters long, and lacked a lot of the skull specialization seen in larger-bodied late Cretaceous forms, like Carnotaurus, suggesting it was more of a generalist predator and were probably the size of a large dog. Its genus name translates to ghost hunter because it was discovered beneath the fossilized remains of another dinosaur entirely, a ghost that unexpectedly materialized during specimen preparation. However, it is especially appropriate because it also helps to fill in a sizable ghost lineage in the abelisaurid fossil record. One specimen of Spectrovenator MZSP-PV833, which is kept in the Museo de Zoologia da Universidade de São Paulo, is all that is known about it. It was found in the Embira Branca range, close to the Coração de Jesus municipality in northern Minas Gerais. A virtually entire skull, a sequence of cervicocortical vertebrae with ribs, a full sacrum, a series of caudal vertebrae, and well-preserved hip and hind limb bones make up the specimen. Numerous characteristics of Spectrovenator's well-preserved skull indicate that it belonged to a taxon that existed between the Jurassic and Late Cretaceous abelisaurids. Its skull similarities to Rugops, another basal abelisaurid, suggest that it may have evolved at a comparable time. The lower jaw muscles may fit in a wider chamber in more derived taxa, but Spectrovenator lacked these adaptations. Instead, the temporal region of the skull showed plesiomorphic or ancestral traits. These characteristics include an extended squamosal process of the postorbital and a wide parietal surface between the supratemporal fossa. Due to these characteristics, Spectrovenator probably had a weaker bite force than abelisaurids that were more descended from it. According to the scientist, this supports the idea that abelisaurid biting force evolved over time and increased. The authors draw the conclusion that only the post-Cenomanian abelisaurids had the requisite adaptations for the abelisaurids' distinctive feeding strategy based on the amount of primitive features displayed by Spectrovenator. The skull of Spectrovenator differs from the crania of other abelisaurids in a few distinctive ways. The ventrally bowed posterior process of the jugal, a nuchal crest with a thin and smooth dorsal margin, a straight ventral margin of the dentaries, part of the lower jaw, with a deep sulcus on the lateral surface, and the dorsal margin of the sura are among them. The posterior ramus of the maxilla is also ornamented with vertically oriented grooves, with the smooth area in front of the max. During the Cretaceous period, which spanned from 145 to 66 million years ago, the Earth's climate was warmer than it is today, and there were no polar ice caps. The average global temperature was around 10 to 15 degrees Celsius warmer than it is today, and sea levels were much higher than they are now. This warm climate created lush tropical forest and shallow seas, which were home to a diverse array of plant and animal life, including the dinosaurs. The Cretaceous period was characterized by a long-term greenhouse climate, with high levels of atmospheric carbon dioxide leading to warm temperatures and a humid climate. However, there were fluctuations in climate during this period, with periods of cooling and warming caused by natural forces such as volcanic activity, changes in ocean currents, and variations in the Earth's orbit and tilt. The Cretaceous period also saw the development of seasonal changes, with wet and dry seasons in some areas. Spectrovenator that have been discovered most likely consumed smaller prey, like lizards, tiny animals, and perhaps insects. Additionally, it's possible that they ate the carcasses of larger animals that other predators had already killed. The Spectrovenator had to be opportunistic feeders in terms of their nutrition, taking use of whatever food sources were accessible in their surroundings. They may have found it challenging to pursue larger species due to their small stature. Thus, they probably concentrated on smaller creatures that they could capture more readily. They are known because of the fossils discovered in South America, Africa, India, and Madagascar, among other places around the globe. The location of the Spectrovenator is what determined their habitat. For instance, if we examine the fossil record of Spectrovenator in South America, we can see that they inhabited a variety of habitats, from marshes and forest to more dry areas. Many of the Spectrovenator relatives have been discovered in areas that were once covered in tropical forests, suggesting that these animals generally preferred warm, humid climates. They most likely inhabited regions where there was an abundance of prey, including smaller dinosaurs, mammals, and reptiles, as well as possibilities for scavenging. Since they would have needed less space and resources to survive, the Spectrovenator may have been able to live in a wider variety of environments than their larger relatives. Although they would have been protected from predators and helped them ambush prey, they probably still preferred areas with lots of cover, like dense vegetation. The social behavior of Spectrovenator, particularly the tiniest known members of this phylum, is little understood. However, we can draw some conclusions about how these animals may have interacted based on what is known about other theropod dinosaurs and their living descendants. The majority of theropod dinosaurs, including Spectrovenator, probably hunted alone and only gathered in groups for mating or to defend territories. It's probable that certain Spectrovenator also exhibited social behavior because some larger theropod dinosaurs, including tyrannosaurs, may have lived in family groups or packs. The competition for resources like food and territory was probably another way that Spectrovenator engaged with one another. They could have had to contend with other predators for scarce food and would have found this to be extremely crucial. Spectrovenator were among the theropod dinosaurs that laid eggs, but offered little to no parental care. They most likely built their nest on the ground or in shallow depressions, lay their eggs, and then let the embryos to hatch and grow. Some Spectrovenator may have engaged in courtship displays, where males would battle for the attention of females by displaying their strength or ornamental features, such as crests or brightly colored markings. When the males and females may have gathered to reproduce during mating seasons, this would have been especially crucial. It's probable that, like other theropod dinosaurs, Spectrovenator had a relatively brief gestation time and that, like other theropod dinosaurs, their eggs grew swiftly, hatching in a matter of weeks. Almost immediately after hatching, the hatchlings would have been fully developed and capable of surviving on their own. Like the extinction of many other dinosaur species, the Spectrovenator extinction is still up for discussion among paleontologists. Climate change, volcanic activity, asteroid impacts, and competition with other carnivores are some of the theories put out as to why they are extinct. One hypothesis is that environmental modifications that took place throughout the Late Cretaceous period, such as variations in climate or sea level, contributed to the demise of the Spectrovenator. This might have caused changes in the vegetation and the availability of prey, which might have had an impact on how long abelisaurids could survive. Another idea is that their extinction was caused by volcanic activity. There were many times of strong volcanic activity during the Late Cretaceous that may have had a substantial effect on the Earth's ecosystems and the climate at large. The Spectrovenator might have been among the many species that perished as a result, and this may have caused extensive environmental upheaval. According to the asteroid impact theory, the Spectrovenator and other dinosaurs may have perished due to a catastrophic collision with a massive asteroid. This notion is backed by the discovery of sediment layers rich in iridium, which is prevalent in asteroids but rare on Earth, in rock layers that date to the extinction. So this was all about the dinosaur ghost hunters of the Cretaceous, Spectrovenator. If you want to get more such updates, hit the bell icon and subscribe to this channel. Also, let us know in the comments section how you find it. By knowing about unique species, we get an idea of how the world, climate, and wilderness was in historic times. We get to know about several new concepts we never knew ever existed. Did you know that there was a sizable carnivorous dinosaur that existed between 112 and 93.5 million years ago during the Cretaceous epoch? It was named Spinosaurus. Click the video on your screen to know more about it.